This next video will show you how to complete Quadrant 4 in the Cal State Apply application. It will also show you how to submit your application as well as how to check for fee waivers. To begin, let's go ahead and select the fourth quadrant, Program Materials. We can see that each university is asking us specific questions and they may be different from each other. Let's go ahead and select Humboldt, the first one. And Humboldt is asking us to review information about the program that I've applied under. After I review it, it automatically checked the left menu, and now I need to review San Marcos. And in San Marcos, there's two tabs. This may be easy to miss sometimes with these sections. So be sure that if you're not seeing a check mark on the left menu, that you're looking for a second tab. And here there is a second tab and there's some questions to answer. So I've already answered these questions. After answering the questions, I click on Save and Continue, which I've already answered. So this was blue and I clicked on it. And once I clicked on it, this check marked. And now I'm ready to answer questions for San Bernardino. So with San Bernardino, there's four tabs. The first tab is a review of the credential program. The second tab are specific questions for the program that I applied under. So we can see here that I answered the questions above about the program. And I want to make sure that I'm reading everything carefully. And here it's asking me to initial. Again, every university is going to ask for different information. So this is just an example for San Bernardino. And here it's asking me to initial that I have read and understood the official transcript requirement. So I'm going to initial that. And now I'm seeing this blue button pop up to save and continue. So let's click on that. And now I need to click on the third tab in order to upload required documents. So I can see here that it's asking for an email from program coordinator, including advisement for program plan and designated subjects admission application. This is because I'm applying under a specific program that's asking for additional documents. So I'm going to upload these documents, and you may see this with other colleges when they're asking for an upload of unofficial transcripts. So here I'm going to click on Add Document, and I should be able to find the documents that it's asking me to upload. I'm going to go ahead and add these documents. We can see that after I clicked on Add Documents, it's now asking me to select the file to upload. So if I click on the blue button and click on Choose File, I'll be able to upload the document. I'm using an example of a document, so I went ahead and uploaded a document. And once I upload the document, it will appear here. Again, this is just an example. So now I'm going to click on Upload This Document. And once it's uploaded, it will show up here and the line will go all the way across. And now I can add a second document. Once I click on Add Document, I'll see the option to upload another file. So if I click on Choose File, I can select another document. And I just went into my computer's documents and uploaded another file. Again, this is just as an example. And now that I've uploaded another file, I see it appear here. And now I can click on Upload This Document. Now I can see that both documents are uploaded in the required documents. Now there's an optional documents option here where it's asking for an unofficial transcript. And then it's asking for work experience. So looks like this is optional. And now I'm going to click on the fourth tab, which is recommendations. So let me click there. And now it's asking me to request a program recommendation. So if I click here, I can enter in a recommender's information. Again, if you're ever asked for recommender information, you want to contact the recommender first and ask them for permission to enter in their information. So I went ahead and entered in recommender's information, and now I'm going to select either yes or no for the waiver of recommendation. There's no right or wrong answer here, that's up to you. And now that I've selected my waiver of recommendation and I've checkmarked both boxes, I see the Save This Recommendation request, and I'm going to click on it. And now I can see that San Bernardino has a check mark. So I should be done with the fourth quadrant. Let's go ahead and check out the dashboard. And sure enough, the fourth quadrant is filled. So now we can move forward with submitting the applications. To submit the applications, we're going to click on Submit Application. To check whether or not I received a fee waiver, I'm going to click on this link. And I am not seeing that I'm eligible for a fee waiver. So if I were eligible for a fee waiver, it would say 4 out of 4 here. So this is telling me that I do need to pay the fee. And if I close this, I can see my fee here, and it's $210. So if you go to Cal State website, so I'm at www.calstate.edu, and in the search engine, type in fee waiver. Click on the fee waiver. And this will give you more information about the fee waiver. This next part is showing you an example of something that you may see if you made any errors on your application. The application is catching them and asking you to review them. So, as an example, we're going to look at Bakersfield and we're going to click on Submit. And it's showing me that there's some sections in the application where it's catching that I may have answered some parts incorrectly. So starting with college coursework, in the section of college coursework in the application, which is quadrant 2, it's catching 3 parts where it thinks I made an error. And if I want to go back and take a look at those or edit them, I can click here where it says go to college coursework. So let's start with the first one. It's saying the following courses were not flagged as transferable. If this is an error, please return to the college coursework page and update. So I listed Psych 101 and Ethnic Studies 101, but I did not flag them as transferable. So these are transferable courses, and I didn't mark them. So I'm going to go back to college coursework, and I'm going to edit Citrus College, and we're going to go to the semester where I listed those classes. So here's Psych 101 and Ethnic Studies 101. And they aren't marked as transferable. So I want to click on the edit button and checkmark the boxes and then click on save. Now we're back in the submit page and we're at the second section where it's catching errors. So it says the following courses appear to be repeated. If the course is recognized as a repeat course on the transcript of the college it was taken at, please go to college coursework and make the first occurrence of the course have a grade of RP. So we actually talk about repeats in one of our videos. It's quadrant 2, Citrus College transcript only. So please take a look at that video to find out where we discuss repeats and how to report repeats. So here it's catching that I took Soc 201. We're gonna actually start here. This is when I first took the course. So spring 2015, I took Soc 201 and I marked the grade as an F and then repeated it in spring 2020 and marked the grade as a B. So what I should have done, because it's the same course and the repeat is recognized by Citrus College, and the F is now disregarded from my GPA, even though I'm seeing the F on my transcript, there is a notation on my transcript showing that the F is excluded from the GPA. So I shouldn't be marking an F here, I should be marking an RP. So I can go back to college coursework and I can edit that. And the third part is showing that the following courses have a grade of F. If this course was repeated or an academic renewal, please return to the college coursework page and update. So again, we talk specifically about this course in another video of ours, which is Quadrant 2 External Transcripts. So we talk about the Anthropology 102. So the F, it's telling me, check out this F, did you repeat it? And in this example, and you'll see it in the video, I did repeat it, but I did not go back to Rio Hondo, which is the first where I received the F. I did not go to Rio Hondo and ask them if they could disregard the F from my GPA based on the fact that I repeated it at Citrus. So that's why I marked it as an F. So right here, it's just kind of like a self-check. It's asking me to just check if it was repeated and it was recognized by the institution where I received the F. If it was recognized, then I need to change this to an RP. But because I didn't do that with Rio Hondo and it wasn't recognized, I'm keeping it as an F. Again, watch our video, Quadrant 2 External Transcripts, and we discuss that, the F. Okay, so now we're looking at general education and it's catching an error, which is that under critical thinking, I clicked on opt out. So if I want to change that, I can go to general education. And here's where I clicked on opt out. And I don't want to do that because, again, as a transfer student, you need to have the Golden 4 courses completed. If you have any questions about that, please meet with a counselor. But we don't encourage you to click on opt out. So I did that with critical thinking and it caught it. So I just want to uncheck it and go back and find the course that is under A3 critical thinking, which in this case is English 103. And then I can save it. So back in the submit or back in the review page, I'm seeing that it's giving me an alert about my test scores. So I reported AP English Language Composition as an exam, and it's letting me know that I will need to send my official test scores if they're requested. So be on the lookout for that. If you are reporting AP credit, you may have to submit your official test score if it's requested. And usually we do see this. I don't think there's a time we've ever not seen it requested. So you will need to order that official College Board score and have it sent to the institution that's requesting it. Now we're going to go to continue, and it looks like it's catching that I'm under 60 transferable credits or units. So in my example of college coursework, I didn't list a lot of courses. So it is under 60 transferable credits, and it's catching that, and I'm glad that it is. So if I see this, I should definitely make an appointment with a counselor and have them recalculate my units to make sure that I will have my required 60 CSU transferable units completed by the deadline. And then here it says warning household income values. So it says, we notice you entered the same income amount for your adjusted gross income, AGI, and your untaxed income and benefits. So let's go back and take a look at that. And sure enough, we can see that I listed the AGI as 10,000, and I also listed the untaxed income as 10,000. So these shouldn't match, these shouldn't be duplicate. So if you have questions about the AGI and the untaxed income, please go to this link up here where it says Applicant Help Center, and it'll give you more information on how to answer the AGI and also what is considered untaxed income. And if you have any questions about that and you want to speak with a counselor, definitely make an appointment with us or come to our CSU application open forum. So going back to the review page, once I acknowledge, so here it's asking me to acknowledge that I've reviewed these. And I'm just doing that to get through this part. Now I can continue to payment, and this is what I should see. So thank you for watching. And again, if you have any questions, please see one of us during our CSU application open forum. You can view the dates and the times and register into those under the Career and Transfer Center page on the Citrus College website under our workshops and events calendar. Thank you.